Hello everyone, this is Ryan with PC Part Picker, and we're back with another build. Today we're doing a high-end HTPC build around $600. Newegg has kindly provided all the parts for this build, including the AMD A10 7870K processor, the Cooler Master Gemini 2 M4 CPU cooler, an Asus A88X+ motherboard, 8GB of G-Skill memory at 2400MHz, a 3TB Seagate hard drive, the Silverstone Grandia Series GD09 case, an EVGA 550W 80+ gold power supply that is fully modular, an Asus Blu-ray drive, and an Asus wireless AC adapter. Let's get started. Our first step is to remove the motherboard from the case and then install the CPU. You'll want to make sure that you take out your I/O plate as well. We'll need this later when we install the motherboard into the case. To install the CPU, you'll want to open the latch on the CPU socket, and then note on the socket itself that there's a little arrow here. You're going to line that up with the arrow on the CPU, and they should fit right together. Arrow is right here on the CPU. Take off the padding. Please be careful, there are pins on the back of the CPU, and if you bend them, it will not work. Set it gently into the socket. Close the latch. Let's take the Gemini 2 M4 out of the box, and we will install it onto the motherboard. This CPU cooler is designed for both Intel and AMD sockets. And for AMD, we're going to need to remove the stock brackets on the socket itself and install AMD-specific brackets onto the CPU cooler. So let's get started. With the AMD brackets removed from the socket, let's take the cooler out of the case and install the brackets to the cooler itself. We have our backplate, our hardware and thermal paste, and the brackets for the CPU cooler. Now let's install the brackets to the back of the CPU cooler. So we'll flip the CPU over and empty out our hardware onto the table. Try to be nice and clean about it. And we have these brackets. One will go on either side, and the bracket goes underneath, and we will screw down into it. With the bracket now in place on the CPU cooler, let's attach it to the motherboard. Before we can attach the CPU cooler though, we need to put these rubber grommets on the socket. We're going to attach these to the holes right around the CPU. These create pressure between the CPU cooler and the backplate and prevent you from damaging the board. Before we install the CPU cooler, we need to apply thermal paste to the CPU itself. Most people will use a drop about the size of a pea or a small grain of rice. Looking at the CPU cooler, you'll notice that there's a piece of plastic on the bottom. This is to protect the copper pipes during shipping. Please make sure you remove this before installing it onto the CPU. Carefully hold the CPU cooler against the motherboard and flip it over so that we can install the backplate. Now let's install the backplate. This CPU cooler comes with a nice little tool to fit right onto the nuts. and then you can tighten them in with a screwdriver. We recommend tightening the nuts in a star pattern to provide the best coverage for the CPU cooler and to make sure that everything fits correctly. With the CPU cooler in place, make sure that you install the CPU fan header onto the motherboard itself. Our CPU fan header is right here. Our next step is to install the RAM into the motherboard. You'll notice that there are little latches on either side of these slots, so let's open those up. Take your DIMM and make sure that you line up the notch on the DIMM itself with the socket. Gently slide it into place and it should click on either side. As you can see, we've used the third and fourth slot to install the memory on the motherboard. This is to avoid any height incompatibilities with the CPU cooler. Also, on this board, the third and fourth slots are the second dual channel memory. If you can't use the first two slots, the third and fourth ones are the correct ones to use. With the case now open, we're going to install the power supply. You'll notice on one side of the power supply is a fan. This is an intake fan. We're going to make sure that we place this face down against the fan grill and the dust filter on our case. So let's slide it into place. Now we're going to secure the power supply into the case with four screws on the back. With the power supply now installed in the case, we're going to remove the optical drive cage and the support bar so that we have easier access for installation of the motherboard. Before you install the motherboard though, don't forget to install your I/O panel. You don't want to build your whole machine just to realize that you left this out. It should snap right into the back of the case. Let's get this case turned around and the motherboard installed. You'll notice on the inside of the case that there are six silver pieces raised. These are the standoffs. We're going to place the motherboard on top of those and then screw them in. This protects the motherboard from shorting out. Line the motherboard up with the holes, and it should slide right into place. The first cables we're going to install into the motherboard are the USB 3.0, power and reset switches, HD audio, and hard drive LEDs. We're doing this before the power supply cables to give us a little bit more room to work with inside of the case. Our HD audio cable is next. Before we install the reset switch, power switch, and LED indicators, refer to your manual to make sure you get the correct orientation. The first cable we're going to plug in is the power LED, and the green is positive. So let's get that right in there. Next, let's install the hard drive LED. The reset switch. And finally, the power switch. On this motherboard, we have two chassis fan headers. The first one is here, and the second one is behind the CPU cooler back here. For ease of use and install, we're going to be using the first slot right here. With the larger components out of the way, we're going to start installing the power supply cables while we have a little room to work with, starting with the 24-pin. Next, we're going to plug in the SATA cable. And finally, the 8 or 4 plus 4 pin CPU cable. Now let's install the 24-pin cable into the motherboard. Before we do that though, we're going to put the SATA cable off to the side while we wait to install the optical drive and hard drive that are going to be right up here. Next, let's install the 4-pin power connector for the CPU at the top of the motherboard. We've got our wireless AC adapter here from ASUS, and it's a pretty cool little device, so let's take a look. On the inside, we have the adapter itself, which is in a gorgeous red, two giant antennas to stick out of the back of your case, an external base for the antennas if you need to move it a little bit further away from your PC, and a low-profile adapter if you ever want to move it to a different case that doesn't have full-size expansion slots. So let's put it in the motherboard. Let's put this right into the motherboard. It should slot directly in. And then we'll screw it into the back of the case. Don't forget to replace the retention bracket after installing the Wi-Fi card. As we're nearing the end of our build, we only have a couple components left to install. This cage will hold both our optical drive and our hard drive, and if you have an SSD, it'll fit that as well. So let's slide the hard drive into the cage, turn it on its side, and make sure that the holes on the hard drive line up with the holes in the cage, and then we'll screw it in. With the hard drive in place in the cage, our next step is to put the optical drive in as well. This will just slide right in through the top, and then we'll turn this on its side so that we can line up the first hole on the cage with the first hole on the optical drive itself. Then all you have to do is screw it in. Our final steps for this build are to install the SATA cables, both data and power, remove the optical drive cover, secure the drive cage, and close it back up. With all of our parts in place, let's push the power button and see what happens. As you can see, we got into the BIOS. Looks like we're all set. All you need now is to install your operating system. So that's our build, everybody. Thanks for joining us. And a big thanks goes out to Newegg for providing the parts of this build. You can find a link to a combo build down below in the description. And if you like the content, please give us a like and subscribe.